hunting small game opener. So this is our first time here. And we're just gonna go walk this trail. Then we're just gonna start cutting in. Probably every 50 to 100 yards. Probably so we're not all bunched together.
Squirrel. Awesome. First squirrel, guys. Yes. I wanted to aim for its head, but it's kind of blocked. Well, guys. We finally got our first squirrel. It's a gray squirrel. Beautiful. I'm gonna field dress it real quick.
always, whenever you harvest an animal, make sure they always give thanks. Doesn't matter if you're a believer or not, or whatever, always give thanks to God or to Mother Nature or whatever. I mean, here, that's the game. This game is giving its life for you. And it's best to, and it's respectful to give thanks for letting you harvest it. Obviously, you may harvest more in the future. It's just respecting Mother Nature, respecting what opportunities that we have here. And this is, and hunting is what it's all about. So I'm gonna finish up here, and then, you know, we're just gonna continue walking down and see if we can find some more squirrels. So. Now sometimes when you see a fallen tree like this, squirrels love to run up and down these fallen trees. Especially in the thick, when it's real thick, it kind of gives them like a open freeway for them to run across. The reason, I think, my opinion is, when they run across, they have a clear path and they can see around them, so they don't have any blocks in the view, and they can see if danger is coming. And I see a lot of squirrels, they always run these fallen trees. So sometimes it's good to just sit, find a good spot, not too close. Right now I'm only about maybe 15 yards from the fallen tree, but I usually like to sit about maybe 30 to 50 yards, and then just kind of watch and observe, and you see if there's any movements around it. And most of the time, yeah, you'd be successful hunting fallen trees like this. So never overlook this spots like this, especially you have a lot of big nice hardwoods all around, and you get all this thick stuff right here. But we're gonna keep on moving. Branches in the way. It's right around 11:30 right now. So far, I only got one squirrel harvested. We did see a whole bunch of them, probably 7 or 8 of them, but they were all far away. And they were just scurrying around on the ground and couldn't get any clear shots. And as soon as I get a clear shot, they seems like they sense it and they just jump. So I couldn't get any shots on any of those. So, but yeah, there's a lot of squirrels here, just trying to get them to stay still or trying to predict where they're going to come from so we can get them. So we got a heifer limit this morning. Only got one. But we're going to try this spot, see how we do here. Hopefully we limit out here.
Guys, oh man, yeah, got him. Wow, big one, big one. Whew. All right, guys. Got him. The first one got him on the legs. Then I had to take a follow shot and got him. Holy cow, his stomach's like all blown up. I'm not gonna show it to you guys. I'm just gonna show you the head right here. That's it. I used this thing to call it in. I heard it up there. Then as soon as I blew this two or three times, I saw it came down the tree so fast. But this really works really good. Especially for gray squirrels. They can't resist it. It's a distress call. Always have your gloves on. I used to field dress them without my gloves.
but I think it's much safer just if you'll address them this way. Then when you guys are done with the gloves, just take it off and just put it in the bag for our disposal later. So don't litter, guys. Don't litter. Alright, let's keep moving. Alright, everyone, adventurers. Hopefully you guys like this episode. We didn't get a limit today, but I did shoot a couple. My brother-in-law's out, they shot a few as well. And it was an overall pretty good day today. It was fun to get out here for the first time in a couple years. So I actually feel pretty good just being out here in the woods. I kind of miss being in the woods. But anyways, hopefully you got some good footage for you guys. And we'll see you on the next video. As always, follow your dreams, follow your passions, make it happen.